गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे इज 29th अप्रैल 2020 एंड वी हैव टू स्टडी अबाउट एडमिशन ऑफ पार्टनर एंड टॉपिक इज एडजस्टमेंट ऑफ कैपिटल अकाउंट इन प्रोपोर्शन ऑफ प्रॉफिट शेयरिंग रेशियो. This is the last topic of third chapter, lecture number 30. Subtopic is adjustment of old partner capital on the basis of new partner's capital. I have already taught in previous lecture about adjustment of capital in two way. First way was determination of capital of new partner on the basis of old partner capital. And now this is second point, adjustment of old partner capital on the basis of new partner capital. In first case, there is no new partner's capital is given in question, but in second case, new partner's capital is to be given in question, and we have to calculate old partner capital on the basis of new partner capital. So I am going to teach second topic for adjustment of capital. A student, sometime the capital of incoming partner is given and capital of old partner is computed on the basis of new profit sharing ratio of partners. Thus, the existing partner capital of old partners be adjusted in two ways. There are two ways for adjusting this. There are two ways. First way is cash basis, and second way is by opening current account of partners. By opening current account of partner, there are two ways. In cash basis, if the new capital is more than the existing capital of partner, he will bring it in cash. On the other hand, if new capital is less than the existing capital of old partner, excess capital is returned back. That means existing partner or old partner may be withdrew their excess cash and bring shortfall cash in the firm. And in second case, in place of cash, we will adjust by opening current account of partner. In case they have fixed capitals, therefore journal entry will be made on the basis of both the way. If point A, if capital of old partner falls short, then he will bring it in cash and adjust it through capital account also. So journal entry will be cash and bank account or current account DR to partner's capital account. And point B, if capital of old partner have a surplus amount, then he will withdraw and adjust it through their current account. So journal entry will be partner's capital account DR to cash and bank account or current account, partner's current account. These are two entry will pass when cash will bring by partner and when surplus amount withdrew by partner. So now I have to go through some practical problem for understanding this topic. Now I have to solve practical problem on the basis of this topic. Suppose A, B and C are partner in a firm in the ratio of 3:2:1. And D is admitted for 1/4 share in profit of the firm, which he get from A, get from A 1/8 and from B and C 1/16 each. It means D gets their shares from A 1/8 share, and from B and C he will get 1/16 from each, then total share will be 1/4. We can calculate 1/8 plus 1/16 plus 1/16 A, B and C. So it will be 1/4. Question says about, now total capital of firm will be 240,000 after all adjustment means revaluation of asset and liability, distribution of goodwill, general reserve, etc. Now next point is given, capital of A, B and C are 80,000, 30,000 and 28,000 respectively is also given and in question. And now question says, calculate capital of all the partner, and give journal entries for doing adjustment in respect of capitals according to the agreement between the partners. Now I repeat once again question. In short, ABCR partner in a firm 3:2:1 ratio. D is new partner, get 1/4 share, and he gets from A 1/8, from B and C 1/16 each, and total capital of firm will be after all the adjustment 240,000. A, B and C capital is given. Calculate capital of all the partners and give journal entries according to new profit sharing ratio. I have to calculate and adjust capital of partner according to new profit sharing ratio. So first I have to calculate new ratio. This share is given 1/4 and he get, therefore is new share will be 3/6 minus 1/8 इट विल बी 18/48। बीज ने न्यू शेयर, बीज न्यू शेयर विल बी 2/6 माइनस 1/16, सो इट विल बी 13/48। एंड सीज न्यू शेयर विल बी 1/6 माइनस 1/16, सो इट विल बी 5/48। Therefore, new ratio of partner will be according to this point 18:13:5:12. It will be new ratio. Now, total capital will be based on new profit sharing ratio. So total capital is given, total capital is given 240,000, and therefore is capital will be 240,000 into 18/48, it will be 90,000. Bees capital equal to 240,000 into 13/48, it will be 65,000. Seed capital will be 240,000 into 5/48, so it will be 25,000 only. Now deed capital will be 240,000 into 12/48, it will be 60,000. Now new capital of partner has been calculated and old capital is also given of old partner. So hence A will brings equal to 90,000 minus 80,000 equal to 10,000. B will brings equal to 65,000 minus 30,000, it will be 35,000. C will withdrew equal to 28,000 minus 25,000 equal to 3,000. And D will bring $60,000, because age capital is given 80,000, but new share is given 90,000. So A will bring 10,000. But C's capital is given 28,000, but she has to keep 25,000 only. So she will withdraw withdrew from firm 3,000. Now journal entry will be journal entry. Bank account DR to age capital account to beach capital account to D's capital account. A will bring 10,000, 35,000 and 60,000. So total will be 1,05,000. And next journal entry will be C's capital account DR to bank account, because C will withdraw 3,000 now. C one more question based on adjustment of partner capital on the basis of capital of new partner. Atul and Madan were partners in a firm sharing profit in the ratio of 5:3. On 31st March 2019, they admitted Mehra as new partner for 1/5 share in profit. The new profit sharing ratio was 5:3:2. On Mehra's admission, the balance sheet of firm was as follow. In liability side, capital of Atul and Madan is given. Provision for bad debt is also given 1,200. Creditor 20,000 and workman compensation fund is also given 32,000. And in asset side, land and building, machinery, patents, stock, debtor, bank and profit and loss account is also given. It will distributed between old partner because it will be loss. Now question says, on Mehra's admission, it will agreed that Mehra will bring 40,000 as his capital and 16,000 for his share of goodwill premium, half of which was withdrawn by Atul and Madan. Second point, a provision on 2.5% for bad and doubtful debt was to be created. Third point, include in sundry creditors was an item of 2,500 which was not to be paid. Fourth point is, a provision was to be made for an outstanding bill for electricity, Rs. 3,000. And fifth point is, a claim of Rs. 325 for damage against the firm was likely to be admitted. Provision be made for the same. Now, at last, question says, after above adjustment, the capital of Atul and Madan were to be adjusted on the basis of Mehra's capital, that means new partner's capital. Actual cash was to be brought in or paid off टू अतुल एंड मदन एज इन केस मे बी. प्रिपेयर रिवैल्युएशन अकाउंट, कैपिटल अकाउंट ऑफ पार्टनर एंड बैलेंस शीट ऑफ न्यू फर्म. सो फर्स्ट वी हैव टू प्रिपेयर फॉर्मेट ऑफ रिवैल्युएशन अकाउंट, पार्टनर कैपिटल अकाउंट एंड बैलेंस शीट. देन आई विल पुट वन बाय वन एज वी हैव डिस्कस इन प्रीवियस चैप्टर. ओनली चेंज विल बी इन पार्टनर कैपिटल अकाउंट, समथिंग विल चेंज एंड ऑल द थिंग विल बी सेम एज we have regularly doing in this chapter. First point is says capital of Atul and Madan 150,000 and 90,000 I will transfer capital account अतुल मदन एंड मेहरा. अतुल मदन एंड मेहरा वी ऑल नो दिस इज पर्टिकुलर्स. पर्टिकुलर्स Now I will transfer their capital in balance sheet. Capital account by balance BD. This is given in question. 150,000 and 90,000 respectively. Now second point is given about workmen compensation fund. And nothing is given in adjustment about workmen compensation. So I will put in capital account credit side workmen compensation fund 32,000 in 5:3. In the ratio of 5:3, so by workmen compensation fund it will distribute 20,000 and 12,000. Now in asset side profit and loss account balance is also given, so it will also shared by old partner. It is loss, so I will write in debit side to PL account and it will shared in 5:3, so it will be 12,500 and 7,500. Now I am going through point wise. Mehra will bring 40,000 as his capital and 16,000 as his share of goodwill premium, and half of which was withdrawn by Atul and Madan. Now I will distribute goodwill also in sacrifice ratio. And sacrifice ratio will be same as old ratio 5:3. So premium for goodwill will be 10,000 and 6,000. Now half of goodwill withdrawn by old partner. So I will write bank account in debit side. It will be 5,000 and 3000 respectively. Now, next point says a provision on 2.5% for bad and doubtful debt was to be created on debtor. Debtor is given 47,000. So, 2.5% of 47,000 will be 1,175, and provision for bad debt is given already 1,200, so 25 rupees will be our income. So I will write in credit side of revaluation account, provision for doubtful debt, provision for doubtful debt, it will be 1,200 minus 1,175, it will be 25 rupees. Now, third point is saying, including in sundry creditor was an item of 2,500 which was not to be paid. It will not paid. So it will our income creditor, I will write creditor 2,500. Now next point is given, a provision was to be made for an outstanding bill for electricity. So it will be our expenses loss because it will create our liability. So I will write outstanding electricity. Now, fifth point, a claim of 325 for damage against firm is likely to be admitted. And provision we made for the same, so it will also create our liability. So I will write claim for damage. Claim for damage 325, and nothing is given about revaluation, so I will calculate balance and it will be our loss 3,325 in debit side, 3,325 in credit side. So loss will transfer into Atul and Madan. It will be 500 and 300. Total difference will be 800. Now I will also transfer the balance of loss in debit side of partner. Loss on revaluation 500 and 300. Now we have to calculate amount of partner capital. So first we will calculate new profit sharing ratio. According to my notebook, first sacrifice ratio will be same 5:3, and second new ratio of new all the partner will be 5:3:2. You have to calculate because this is to be taught in previous lecture. Now, according to this, Mehra will bring 40,000 capital. So, I will write, since 2 by 10th share of capital equal to 40,000, so total capital will be 40,000 into 10 by 2. Total will be 2 lakh. Therefore, Atul's capital will be 2 lakh into 5 by 10, it will be 1 lakh. Therefore, Madan's capital will be 2 lakh into 3 by 10 equal to 60,000. And Mehra's capital is given in question, 40,000. So I will write balance of capital. 2 balance CD, it will be 1 lakh. 60,000 and 40,000. Now, in credit side, I have to also write bank account for Mehra's capital, 40,000. Now, I will balance it. Total of Atul capital will be 1,80,000. Madan's capital will be 1,08,000. And Mehra's capital will be 40,000. And in debit side also, 1,80,000, 1,08,000. And 40,000. Now you can see Atul and Madan capital is excess than they have to keep in business. So excess capital will withdraw by old partner bank account, it will be 62,000. When I will deduct 1,80,000, 1,12,500, 5,000 and 500, it will be balancing figure, and it will calculated in last, because I have already calculated balance CD. And same Madan capital will be 37,200. Now partner capital account has been completed, and we have to show balance sheet also. So capital account of Atul, Madan, Mehra will be 1,60,000 and 40,000. Now in liability side, creditor is given. Creditor now will be 17,500 because 2,500 we have not to pay. Claim for damage. Claim for damage will be 325 rupees only. And outstanding electricity bill will be 3,000. And in this question, bank overdraft also will be calculated. So see how it will be bank overdraft. Bank balance is given in question 4,200. Bank overdraft equal to 4,200 is given our previous balance. And C brings his capital 40,000 and 16,000 as his share of premium. But 8,000 of premium withdrawn by old partner, half of premium, and also withdrawn 62,000 and 37,200 by old partner because their capital is excess. So remaining balance will come in minus 47,000. So it will treated bank overdraft and hence it will write in liability side of balance sheet 47,000. Now in asset side, land and building is also given 150,000 and machinery 40,000 and patent 5,000, stock, this is given in question, stock 27,000 and debtor 47,000 minus provision. Now provision will be 11,275 only because it will be now 2.5% only. So it will be 45,825. Then I will total the balance sheet. I will write balance sheet of Atul Madan and Mehra. Total balance sheet will be 2,67,000 and 825 in both side. 2,67,825. Now you can see this is your solution. And rough work also you can see. This is your rough work for this question. Now, thank you.